So I'm thinking, so I'm new to the game, I guess, because when did it ever become a toxic thing to be masculine?
Is this toxic masculinity?
All right.
Professor Sean.
Who do you call when you are at your lowest? Who is that one person?
Nobody. I'm a man. No one cares.
Not a single soul. Nobody.
No one. Because I'm all alone.
Speaking for the guys when I say this, literally no one.
Y'all call someone?
Nobody. Just nobody.
No one. Oh. So,
you guys.
No one.
Another episode of The Uncomfortable Truth. Look, today's topic is, does toxic masculinity exist? So we had the little preview of a video that kind of gives you some, you know, I guess, background or just a little bit. But however, it talks a little bit about toxic masculinity. And I know my boy Mitch, he can probably tell me all about it. I need you to educate me. What would you call toxic masculinity?
Well, first of all, Kane, shout out to the family, the congregation and everything. But I don't need you to yell at me. I don't need you to yell at me because I think that might have been very toxic with you raising your voice at me like that. So I don't know. But yeah, toxic masculinity, that's been a subject that we've been hearing about on the news. In these YouTube streets and everything. And they're saying men are displaying too much testosterone in everything. And that could be toxic to the kids that's coming up, to other people. But we have testosterone. We are men. And we should train up a child. Oh, I don't want to get biblical with y'all. Train up a child the way it should go. And when he departs, he would not. Okay. But toxic masculinity, I think that term, it wasn't around 30 years ago, 40 years ago. But in this modern era, it's not good to show that you are a man. We need men to protect, right? We do need men to protect.
For sure.
You want all of this.
For sure.
But then I'm being ridiculed or other people are being ridiculed for displaying this. When something happens, it's a fire in the building. If I'm around, I'm going to try to help somebody. I'm going to try to save somebody. Is that toxic? Because I'm a man, I'm going to run in there? Think about it, people. What do you have
bro,
to say,
bro?
On that?
Bro. So I'm thinking. So I'm new to the game, I guess. Because when did it ever become a toxic thing to be masculine? Right. Just because I'm masculine, I'm taking charge. I'm taking charge. I'm saying, all right, this need to be done. This need to be done. Or whatever the situation is, I'm going in there and I'm handling that situation. Why is that toxic?
Don't raise your voice. That could be toxic. That could be toxic.
To who? To other men or to women?
I could feel threatened.
Women feel toxic? They feel like you can't be so masculine around me. Is that what it is? Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. So you're saying if it's toxic and I'm being masculine and I'm being in my masculine form and I'm taking charge and I'm taking care of business, whatever that business may be, but I'm doing that. If I'm doing that, then the women should embrace that. Now, if the women are saying, we equal.
Mm-mm.
No, you're not. I disagree with that. You know, you're not equal. Yeah, you're equal as in, you know, you're a human being. I get it. I get it. Yeah, I get that. I get that. But as far as in, you know, what the men do and what mm-hmm. women do, and that's probably getting to the roles and everything. But guaranteed, the women will pick and choose. They kind of like cherry pick. They cherry pick on what they want to be equal to.
Well,
why is that? Because it can be toxic. Would it be toxic in saying that I'm got my own business and I'm a roofing company. I'm a roofing company. I got my own business. Would it be toxic for me to only have men? Well, hell, ain't no women standing in line trying to be, or you know, help me out with this roofing business.
Well, I see what you're saying on that, but to the degree of this so-called toxic masculinity, that's just if you're showing over, if you're being over, we'll say you're showing too much testosterone. You might be too aggressive.
With
your talk, with your demeanor, because it might be considered overbearing.
So why you just can't say it's aggressive behavior versus toxic behavior?
Masculinity.
Yeah. If I'm a male, why can't you just say, all right, he's just an aggressive guy. That's the only way he can get his point across, by being aggressive, not being direct, not being assertive, but being aggressive. Why you can't just say that? What's toxic about it?
I feel it's nothing toxic about it, but that is a big point right there. Being assertive, but you could offend somebody. Now this 2023, we all in, I feel threatened. You shouldn't do that. You done heard it. You done seen it. I don't think that as far as toxic masculinity, that we as men should stray away from it, because we have to raise men. And that's what we talk about. But if we demasculate the men, what are we going to have?
Well, check this out, bro. All right, so toxic masculinity, this topic that we're talking about, who came up with it? Women? Or is it a bunch of guys that came up and say, man, we're being too aggressive with these women? Hey. Was it women? That's my question, nephew.
Kane.
Yeah, okay. So
Kane, I can't give you 100%, but I believe it was men, Kane. I believe it was men.
Oh, so it's men just saying that we're toxic to other men and women?
Conforming to the modern day standards.
But what are these standards? We set the standards. What are these standards you're talking about?
You say we set the standards.
Yes.
I can't agree with that.
Who's setting it then? What are you gonna say, the government? What are you gonna say?
Men are not setting these standards.
Women?
Do you think men?
Just say it.
Men would come out with that. Men, I mean, that's being a man, okay? That's being a man. That's just showing a form of, this is what we're gonna do. I'm here to do this. I'm here for protection and all of that. But now, the man of the, let's just say the 70s.
Who's complaining? Are men complaining?
No,
or women complaining?
Women are complaining.
All right, so who said
the feminine men are complaining? Who set the standards then?
You said men and women? So
what kind of
men? We talking about straight gay? Are we going there?
We're not going there. We're not going there.
So
because
what we're saying?
I said feminine men. Okay.
Feminine men.
I would say feminine men, because I say this right here. Okay. Everybody, family, congregation, because I got to put it out there, because now we have to say this right here.
Yeah.
You have to be choosy. And I'll go ahead and say it. You have to be choosy with your words now. Okay, this politically correctness and our podcast, Uncomfortable Truth, all of that, we believe we want everybody to feel safe in who you are and what you believe and all of that stuff. But we have to tell the truth. It's uncomfortable, people. It is uncomfortable.
Yes, but, it's uncomfortable, but you gotta speak up.
Yes.
So why should this even be a term? Why should this, do you think it should be a term? Do you think that toxic masculinity should be a term that's in, you know, you can probably put it in Google and come up with whatever the definition is. I know at the beginning we had what Google says or where somebody has, you know, presented that or
it's
whatever.
Many definitions.
Definitions. Yes. So people just come up with what they want to come up with. Right. So who's setting these standards? There's a bunch of guys sitting in the back coming up with what toxic masculinity is.
I don't
know. Was it some women that come up with this?
I definitely don't.
Come on.
I don't think so. Not us. It's not us because
it's not me.
I want to serve and protect. I want to serve and protect. That's what I want to do.
Yeah. Yeah.
I want to lead. I want to serve and protect. So with that being said, I don't think that's toxic. I don't think it's toxic because men have to be leaders. Men
where did
defend.
It come from, though? That's my thing. Where did it come from, nephew? Where did it come from, Mitch, man? If that's how I feel and that's how you feel, and most men feel this way,
yeah.
Then where did it come from,
Kane? I don't know
where
if
did it ever
the
become
bathroom.
Toxic. And toxic is something that you don't want to be around, right?
It's waste. Yes.
Yes.
It could kill you. Yes.
Yes. So if it's toxic, disease. You don't want to be around there and you avoid it at all costs, right?
At all costs. You're right.
All
right. Yes.
So that's what toxic is. Now we're saying masculinity. So you're saying that somebody's just too aggressive? Why don't you just say they are aggressive? Because a lot of times I get this. So some people feel like being a leader and being aggressive really gets people to follow you. A lot of times it doesn't. It doesn't. You don't have to be aggressive to get people to follow you.
That's true.
And some people are passive aggressive and things of that nature. But you don't necessarily have to do that. But I'll tell you this. If you're assertive and direct, people will follow you. They may not like you at the beginning because it's not what they're used to, but they will respect you.
You saying that's respect. They will respect you.
Yes.
Because
that's what you want.
Yes.
That's what you want.
I believe in that.
Yeah. So this toxic stuff doesn't exist. It's nothing toxic about it. In my sense. Now, Mitch, I don't know what you say. You say it may be existing, and you say that maybe a man or a woman or whoever put it together or whatever, but I say it don't exist. I say, yeah, we got aggressive people. For sure.
Yeah.
Of course you got aggressive people. You know?
But Kane, hold up.
What's up?
You've been a little toxic right now I'm feeling like your toxic masculinity is overpowering this conversation. I feel threatened, Kane.
Why should you feel threatened, though, nephew? So you feel threatened because we've been in the military, right? All right. So I'm gonna give you this example, right? So you've been in the military. We've both been in the military. We retired, whatnot. So when you're in the military, people feel like, especially no matter what their stature is, you know, if they're, you know, sergeant major, if they're, you know, whatever, right? But they feel like if I talk loud, I am of power. And people will follow that. A lot of people will follow that.
Yeah.
But I noticed throughout my whole career, just because they got a loud voice doesn't mean that they are anything but just talking. I noticed that they just kind of running their mouth. They're just running their mouth. That's all they're doing. Just saying, this and that or whatever. And y'all need to be doing this. Blah, blah, blah. I'm like, whatever. You got the rank. I respect the rank, but I don't respect
Thank you. Thank you.
I don't respect you, but I respect the rank. Because you're just, so nobody's really following you. They following the rank, not you. You know what I'm saying? So that's basically what that is. So, and he's just talking aggressive. And you don't capture everybody by being aggressive. You don't. Because some people will shut you out.
They will tune you out. Say it again.
Yeah, yeah, they will. They will. It's like, dude, this dude is yelling. This dude is whatever. But being toxic, I mean, I guess if you were to ask somebody, they'd be like, oh, yeah, that's an aggressive male. Okay. Then you just gave him a new name. Toxic masculine.
Well,
If that's what the case is, I want you to explain it to me, because I feel like it don't exist, but, or maybe they just transform the terminology.
Well, I think this, and I believe this, people, and this is my belief, okay? Roger that. This Mitch belief, that saying toxic masculinity, what are we trying to do to the men? Okay, to the men, to our young sons that we have to raise, saying that it's toxic masculinity. When we grow up as boys, as kids, boys, and they playing football, they doing sports, they pushing each other, they might fight. They might get loud with each other and push. Now, I remember back in the day when I was a kid and we would play football, peewee football. Somebody would win. The champion at the end of the little season would get a trophy. Everybody wouldn't get a trophy. Now, 2023, 2022, 2019, everybody gets a participation trophy. Now, everybody, because the feelings,
that's toxic.
That is toxic, because it is winners and losers. So in life,
yes. If you're gonna do that, you're teaching the youth that everybody is a winner, when in life everybody is not a winner. So there's a first place, second place, third place. If you're not first, you're last, and you're it doesn't matter. You didn't win, but that's okay, because you can't win at everything that you compete in.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? And right. You have to. That's the type of put across. Not that everybody is okay. Tell all the kids you did well, or we're not even counting all the points that the team score. I've seen that in the past where they'll have a basketball game and they're shooting a bat. You can see, you know who won. You know who won, but everybody's like, we didn't even keep the score. The score clock ain't even on or whatever.
But I can tell you this, Kane, what you just said, okay? And in this day and time, just a buddy of mine who had a kid that's in Pee-wee or whatever. He was teaching his son, no, y'all didn't win. You didn't win. Y'all won. Yes. Y'all won two games out of the little 8-game season. Mm-hmm. And the kid was like, no, you can't say that. And people talked to the father and said, hey, why you teach? He a winner. No, he didn't win.
No.
And parents talked to him, you know, not confrontational.
Yeah.
But just, hey, you can't teach us. No, I got to teach my son. You can't win. You're not number one at everything.
Yes.
When did everything change? Yes. When did it all change to say that, okay, everybody get a participation trophy, or everybody is number one?
That's toxic masculinity.
Thank you. But I got one question. I got one question. I got one question. I got one question. And this, people in the comments, just talk, respond, all of that. If there is a thing of toxic masculinity, is there a thing as toxic femininity? And I don't want you to, and I have to say this because this today's culture that we live in, I have nothing against women. I love women. I support women. Advocate, all of that. But if it's toxic masculinity, is there a such thing as toxic femininity?
Of course. If you're going to say, you say aggressive, what is this here? This is the willfully ignorance and a heavy sense of entitlement. Come on now. Nobody is entitled to anything in life. You work for whatever. You know what I'm saying? Nobody. I don't care if you're male or female. Doesn't matter. You know what I'm saying? So, yes, there could, I agree, there can be toxic femininity. I get it. You know
what I'm saying? Can I say this?
To take responsibility.
Can I say this? We don't need no man to do nothing.
Yeah.
We don't. We can be independent. I don't need a man to raise a kid. I would rather have a kid and not have the man so I don't have to deal with him.
Garbage. That's exactly what that is. That's straight garbage. Like, so, and that's toxic. That's toxic to the to that male or female child. That's toxic to them. And that's what rolls into what we see today in society. And the way that people are not moving forward, they still stuck because of that toxicness. That's what I think. So, for me, for my final thoughts, I mean, what you want to say, you can say that it exists and all this other stuff. I get you the aggressive male. I get it. Because aggressiveness, yes, some people will be aggressive in certain situations or whatever, and they think they're getting their point across or whatever. And sometimes that shut people down and they don't listen. That's one of those, you know, leadership 101 type thing or whatever. Because, I mean, we deal with that in the military or whatever. Assertive, being direct, people will respect you. I don't care if they don't like you because of whatever the case may be. But if you're assertive and direct, they know that they can trust you and anything can happen and they will follow you. I'm telling you.
And you're not going to waver.
Toxic masculinity, whatever. I call it aggressiveness. And aggressiveness, people don't really follow that or whatever, but we just let them talk or whatever. But go ahead.
Well, my final thought is family, congregation, I don't believe it exists. And even when I was playing around when I was saying, Kane, you talking too loud. That's toxic. No. He had passion when he was talking because he believed in what he said. I believe in what I say. But at no point in time did we discredit any woman or any man that doesn't exude what we have right now. Okay? And you don't have to be a man that's lifting weights and all of this stuff, but men, be men. Men, raise your kids or whatever. Whoever came up with toxic masculinity, I don't believe it exists. That's my final thoughts on it.
That's the uncomfortable truth. For sure.
For sure. And last thing before we cut, is it your truth or is it the truth?
Is the truth.
The truth. Thank you.
That's all it is.
That's it.
For sure.
Thank you.